Hey guys, today we'll be looking at the HP Pavilion 15. So this device came out in 2019 and I've been using it for 3 months now, and this is my review on it. So we are going to begin with a one hand open test, and you will be able to notice that it does not pass this test, and that's because the hinge is tight. So with time it's gonna loosen up and you should be able to open the laptop with one hand. So that's it for the one hand open test, and now we're going to booting up this device. And just a reminder, this device here is using an SSD 1 terabyte, but it comes with either a 500 gig hard drive or a 1 terabyte, but I changed mine to an SSD for better performance. So as you can see, it doesn't take time to boot, and we're already done with the boot up test. And into the device, you can see I also have to customize something to make it look very good and clean. So that's it for the boot up test here. So over to the internet speed now. This really depends on your internet connection. So I'm going to go into apple.com. So if you are wondering why I didn't talk about the specs of this laptop, then they are down in the description below, and I'll also say that right now. So this device comes with a 16 gig installed RAM, and you either get it with the 1 terabyte hard disk or the 8 gig RAM version or the 500 gig hard disk. It comes with the Intel Core i7 processor with a clock speed of 1.8 gigahertz, which can go beyond that top and about 4.5 gigahertz. It comes with pen and touch support. You either get it with the Windows 10 Pro or the Windows 10 Home, and it's also a 64-bit operating system. For the graphics card, it comes with the Nvidia GeForce MX250 and dedicated 2 GB of RAM. So far my typing experience has been good on this device because it gives you a very satisfying key trial, because you have to apply enough force so you won't make mistakes while trying to type, compared to other keyboards like the one we had on the MacBook Pro, which has been fixed now. So both the keyboard and the touchpad are great on this device, and if you like typing at night, that shouldn't be a problem for you because you have the backlit keyboard. So this is a random photo I took at night while typing, and as you can see, the light beneath the keyboard is bright enough for you to see while typing. So as for me, it's great in terms of typing. So in terms of video editing, I would not recommend this device because you would not enjoy it while trying to do some editing. I would recommend the Dell XPS 15 or the MacBook Pro 16. If you try editing work on this device, if that light tack is able to do that for you, but heavy work and long videos for YouTube and other media, it would not be a funny experience, because I'm also using this to edit this video and I'm experiencing a lot of lags, and the system is very hot. So but if you think you can bear with that and be very patient, so you can go with it. But for me, I won't be using this to edit any of my work. And can get any other laptop out there which is good and have a dedicated graphics card for video editing and picture editing.